Welcome to a first video on another fish technique interface or control set. In this case it is the Bluetooth control set, which works on well, amongst other battery set, then Bluetooth controlled set of motors 3 and a servo motor, and of course the control set with joysticks. Now I did some preparation and I managed to pair the whole thing, which for Bluetooth means that whenever I power up everything should work. So what's a controller without motors? I tested it already, and well, basically it should be working. So when I reconnect the battery that is in here, and I connect it with this battery pack, which is fully charged, or should be fully charged by now, then everything should work. So let's connect everything again and see if it works, and then perhaps I can build another driving robot with it without programming it, because that's the difference with my other controllers. Those have to be programmed, and this one can just be manually controlled. So let's see. Right, so on screen, no terminals to execute commands. I just have added the schematics. Motor 1, motor 2, motor 3. And yes, the not connected motor is going to be on motor 3, motor output 3. And why? Because according to the manual, these two are controlled by only this one, and then this one is controlled by the other one. So what I am now going to do is connect this, and then before I can do anything further, I have to reconnect the battery. And why haven't I done that before? I don't know exactly, but why do I disconnect it? Well, to save power, because another battery that I used before was completely empty. And before a 9 volt battery is empty, that takes a while. So to be very sure, I just disconnected it, and now you see it flashing because it has no contact. I am connecting the battery pack now. It automatically pairs, so this means that now both this servo motor and this motor should be working. Well, and then it turns out that this motor is now working on my commands. Just a very little bit. Can I have that on better display? Maybe here. You can see it, I hope.
So that what makes me wonder if this one, if this joystick is for the servo, then what happens if I connect this motor to either one of those, to either two or three. Let's connect and find out. Okay, so now I have wired motor 2, and I am first, according to manual, connecting it to motor output 3. See whatever happens. So okay, on, then, and now, indeed, oh, this is interesting. So this one is now connected to motor output 3, and if I move this joystick sideways, the servo works. If I move it the other way, obviously the power motor works. And a little bit different, then they move both. Not much. So, sideways. And then they move at the same time. Then once again the other one. Okay, so what happens if I move motor 3 to the other one, to motor output 2? Then also sideways is one motor, and forward is the other. Both at the same time. Forward is one motor, side pure sideways is the other. So it's interesting, because how then do I move it forward when I have it mobilized, as in making making a driving robot? That's an interesting one. So now I know that M3 is connected to the servo, and M1 and 2 are connected, or more appropriately, this one is for M3 output at servo, and this one is for motor output 1 and 2. The only point is that the servo only moves certain amounts, certain bits, a little bit back and forward. But let's see how this works out if mounted. And that's going to be a challenge with the parts, but this is a nice idea anyway. All right. point, building a carriage or driving assembly is going to take some more time, so I will postpone that to next time. In the meantime, the schematics, right side, and left side, and left side joystick. Now, what you can see, of course, is this is not M3, but this is servo. And then immediately you can see the motors are the same. Well, unfortunately, this program does not have, that I know, the separate symbol for a servo motor. And when I try to connect this wire here, I have to connect it either here or here. So I'm leaving it undone. It is connected, but so be it. Then a battery pack for whatever I leave for next time. Can I connect a third motor? Of course I can. I have one left. So that is an option. And everything else is for next time. Also, I want to find out if the behavior of the servo motor now with the joystick is as to be expected, because that's another thing. Then this connectivity LED has gone off, so I have I should press the on button to do anything. So that's one thing. Disconnect the battery for power saving, and then we'll see whatever happens next.
So that is it for now. Powering on, controlling everything again, and maybe in this camera you can see it much more clearly, but I doubt it, to be honest. No, even I can see through the camera lens. Anyway, that's it for now. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, please subscribe to my channel and give the video a thumbs up. Leave a comment or suggestion, much appreciated. You can also follow me via Instagram and Twitter. Please be so kind to show your appreciation by making a donation via either PayPal or Wired Banking. And for more information about that, please see my website. You can also become a patron, and depending on the pledge you make, may have your name mentioned on my website and with my videos. This is, of course, going to be continued. So for now, have a nice day, and see you later. Bye bye. And see also the next short segment with all relevant information about social media, website, and email.